explained?
I don't know. You can't explain it. I mean, I don't think there's a word in the dictionary right now that I could pick or choose to really show the emotion that I felt when I touched that wall. I think it was, oh my God, I've won the Olympics. This is the ultimate event. It's, you know, the Sydney crowd have just been unbelievable. It's here in your own country. You know, it was every bit of expectations, the Olympics, you know, that I've had within me, you know, it achieved. And it was just really a dream come true.
Because I've got to tell you, you had Sydney and I think you had Australia worried. In the week leading up to this, they were saying, hang on, is Grant okay? Was Grant okay?
No, Grant wasn't probably nowhere near his full potential, I think, during this week. You know, I've trained unbelievable. I've trained a lot better than I have in the past, and I really expected to smash all my PBs and do a lot better in the 200 and 400 metre freestyles early in the week. And to be, you know, quite honest, it was a shock to swim that slow in those early events, and I knew I had a job to do. People were writing me off, and at the same time, I still had unbelievable support from the public, which has just been enormous. And, you know, I was just thrilled to bits. I mean, it's just a dream come true, like I said. And the scenario, I think, was a dream. I mean, to have Kieren alongside me and to be first and second, it's awesome.
Your reaction, you slammed that water as if it had done something rather nasty to you. Was there a message in that?
I mean, I'd been, you know, written off, you know, basically all week by a numerous amount of people. And I guess it built up an anger within me. It does. It does. I don't care how mind strong you are. When someone says something, of course, it, you know, it takes a little bit away. But you know, you've really just got to be focused on yourself and know what you can achieve. And I mean, what I did is I just put it all into motivation. I mean, anything that anyone said, negative or positive, I put within me. And I mean, I just, pardon me, had this anger in me, and like not a destructive anger, but an anger to, you know, not only prove to myself what I'm capable of, but you know, prove all those people out there that, you know, it's not over till it's over. And I might have been down, but I sure wasn't out.
Kieren, congratulations again. Let's talk tactics. Fastest qualifier. Did you spend the gold medal early?
Maybe. I don't think so. But, you know, yesterday morning swim, I guess in my own mind, being in the first heat and not really knowing how the rest of the field was going to go, and I knew that it was going to be tough to make the final, I just had to get out there and do it. I had to get a good swim, had to swim fast, and, you know, I'm a notoriously bad heat swimmer, so, yeah, it really was a bit of a turn-up for the books for me to swim as quick as I did. I didn't feel too bad today. You know, I was a little bit sore here and there, but nothing that was going to affect me tonight. And, you know, I swam 5 seconds faster than I did in Atlanta, so, you know, I certainly think that I got the best out of myself.
What about tactics? What were the tactics, and did Grant spoil yours?
No, not really. I mean, I knew that, because he beat me. But I knew that he was going to go out fast, and it was important to me that I go out with him as close as I could. I knew that I didn't have the same all-out speed, but I had to get away from the rest of the field as well. The Americans finished very strongly. And I hoped that in the middle part of the race that I might have been able to peg back the distance on Grant and, you know, turn it into a bit of an all-out race at the end. But at the same time, I had to make sure that I didn't let the others pull me back either. So, you know, all in all, I think it was probably the best tactics that I could have employed. If I'd have gone out too hard, I probably wouldn't have been able to hold on the end and may have missed out on a medal. And if I'd gone out too slow, I certainly wasn't at any stage going to give Grant a shake. So, you know, I think from my point of view, the race probably panned out as best as it could have.
Grant has been under unquestionable pressure in the past fortnight, and people have been asking questions. I think you've been under the pump now for probably 4 years. It's been a real roller coaster ride. As a married man, as a family man with two young children, has it been a very difficult roller coaster?
It has. It has. You know, as Grant said, when people say things about you, it doesn't matter how strong you are mentally, they get through eventually. And, you know, when you continually read that you've got no chance and that you passed it and that, you know, you should have given up on a high after Atlanta, I mean, that sort of stuff does get to you. But, you know, from my point of view, I think that I knew that I had a good shot here. It was important to me to be involved. You know, I was in Monaco in 93 when the team was announced. I was part of the bid team, and to know that I could finish my career in Sydney in front of what has been, without a doubt, the best swimming crowd I've ever been in front of.
Amazing atmosphere, isn't it?
Look, you couldn't... I couldn't have asked for a better finale, you know. Well, maybe a tiny little bit bad, but...
Sorry about that.
Oh, no.
I don't think you are.
No, I'm actually not.
And look, I don't... nothing against it either, you know. For me personally, I got the best out of myself tonight, and I know that... the crowd was fantastic. It was a fantastic scene, and you know, I have to say, I'd prefer to be beaten by an Aussie than anybody else.
The feeling at the medal presentation, Grant, the sacrifices you've made over the years, was it an emotional moment for you?
Definitely. I mean, it was. It's like I said, it's a dream. Every day I've thought of this. I mean, I remember when I was 12, 13 years old, saying I want to win an Olympic gold medal, and. I just achieved it, you know. Like, I really didn't know how to take it, to be honest.
Do you think people understand and appreciate the sacrifices that you've had to make to get to this level and to attain this?
I don't think anyone can appreciate it until they do it, to be totally honest. I think the only way you can appreciate it is if you're actually in there doing the laps, getting up early in the morning. Even my mum says to me and my dad, I don't know what you do. I don't know how you do it, whatever you do, you know. Basically, you know, I leave at 4:45 in the morning, then I come on home at about, you know, 8 o'clock. And it's something, I guess, within, you know, that you can only really be thankful for. I mean, people around you definitely have a huge understanding of what it's like to win an Olympics and, well, not quite win, but, I mean, understand, you know, the work and, you know, the satisfaction of being able to get up and do a job. But at the end of the day, I think you're the one who really, really appreciates it. But, I mean, you just have enormous support around you and people that help and drive you. I mean... I've just been listening to the voicemail on my phone. I've had friends crying to me and stuff like that. So it's been pretty awesome.
Well, it has been worth it. Congratulations.